This is Taylor with how to make a table of contents in Word, which I've broken down into three easy sections for you. Properly formatting your Word document to make your table of contents, updating and customizing your table of contents, and navigating your table of contents in Word. And then as a bonus at the end, I'll show you how to use everything you learned in this video to quickly convert Word to PowerPoint to jumpstart your next presentation. Section 1, properly formatting your Word document. And here in Microsoft Word, it looks like I have a Word document that's properly formatted with a title, some sections that are in bold, some other sections, some subsections, but in fact, this document is not properly formatted to make a table of contents, and you can know that because if I click into my document, I come to the References tab, I open up Table of Contents, and I insert a Table of Contents, notice that no Table of Contents entries are found. So this is a classic 101 mistake by not properly formatting your Word document to create a Table of Contents. And let me just remove this Table of Contents. So what you need to do is you need to first format your document to create that Table of Contents. And here's another classic 101 mistake. So to create a Table of Contents, we need to use the Header 1, Heading 2, and Header 3 styles, and I'll show you how to create or get the Header 4 styles into your Table of Contents later, but the classic mistake is to label your document title, using the Header 1 style. If you do this, as I'll show you later in this video, this will show up in your Table of Contents, when in reality, what you want to use is this title heading style. So you want your title to be the title, and I'll show you how you can change this formatting in just a second. For Section 1, we want to, again, from the Home tab, open up the Styles dropdown. You can see the Header 1 style. So we want our sections to be Header 1, and there's a keyboard shortcut for that, which is Control-Alt-1. And notice I don't have to first select everything. I can just click in, Control-Alt-1 will automatically apply that Header 1 style. For my subsections, so this will be Control-Alt-2. I can use my keyboard shortcut. This is the fastest way to double your productivity in whatever program you're using. And if you don't like the formatting that comes with this, you can do one of two things. The first thing is, if you come to the Design tab, you can notice that you have all these different formatting styles. So you could just simply choose, this one's green. Notice the subsections change as I hover over these different design styles. So this is one way, you just simply select and you can open this up and see all the different formatting options you could have or have automatically applied to your document. The other way to do this, if you just select the header style, so this is section or level 2, you format it any way you want. I'll just make it orange and I'll make it size 18, so it kind of stands out, and hits enter. If you then come up to the styles gallery, either open it up or just right click the heading style that it is, notice you have this update heading to match section. If I select update heading to match section, you'll see that all my section or level 2s will automatically take that orange formatting. So I'm going to Control-Alt-3, I'll just do this quickly. Section 3 should be Control-Alt-1. And finally, Section 4, Control-Alt-1. So those are your heading style keyboard shortcuts, Control-Alt-1, Control-Alt-2, and Control-Alt-3 for Heading 3. I'll then Control-Home to jump back to the top of my document. I've now properly formatted the document. So if I come to the References tab, I come and open the Table of Contents dropdown, I can select Table of Contents, and you can see a Table of Contents is inserted into my document, and the document title is not stuck there in my Table of Contents. So this is the proper way, using the Header 1, 2, and 3 styles, to format a Word document to make a Table of Contents in Word. Section 2, updating and customizing your table of contents in Word. The next important thing to understand about a table of contents in Word is how to properly update it. So for example, as we expand out our document, let me just Control V to paste in. I'll call this 1.2. I will Alt Control 2. Again, I don't have to select all of the text first, just Alt Control 2. I will Control C to copy this. So I'm going to add two new sections. I'll call that 1.3. I'm also going to make the classic mistake I mentioned earlier, and that classic mistake is to label your title as Alt-Control-1. Same thing as just coming up here and applying the header style 1. You don't want to make this mistake, but I'm going to make it for you just to see what happens. Now notice that even though I've now changed my title and I've added those subsections, nothing's changed inside my table of contents. Even if I Control-S to save on my keyboard, nothing changes. So to update your table of contents after you've expanded your document, you need to click in, click Update Table either here. You also have the options here in the References tab. Clicking Update Table, you get two options. The first option is to update page numbers only, which will only update the page numbers for whatever is currently in your table of contents. So you need to be careful here because even after I just expanded that document or this document, if I just select this and click OK, nothing is going to update because those sections that I added are brand new. That's why I always recommend when updating a table of contents that you select Update Entire Table, click OK. You're going to see my document title is now inside my table of contents, which I actually don't want. And then I have those two new sections. So let me just quickly scrub out this classic mistake. I'll come to the Home tab. I will come, open up, label it as a title. I will then just quickly update my table of contents, update entire table, click OK, and we're good to go. So now let's look at customizing this even further. So right now we have level 1, level 2, and level 3 inside our table of contents. Are you still with me? What happens if you want to go to level 4, 5, 6, or 7? So for example, if we come down, let's make this section 1.3. Let's come to the Home tab. Let's come and open up this dropdown, and let's just label it heading 4. So we want a fourth heading level inside our document. If I come back to the table of contents, update, update entire table, watch this section 1.3 as I click OK, 1.3 disappears. So level 4, 5, 6, 7, etc. will not automatically come into your table of contents. If you do want to add those, what you need to do is come and first remove your table of contents from Word, remove table of contents, it disappears. Let's click back in, let enter. This is where I want my table of contents, references, table of contents dropdown. This time we need to select custom table of contents. Selecting custom, notice that we have some options here. First off, you have the ability to show page numbers or not show them. I recommend always showing your page numbers, otherwise what's the point of having a table of contents in the first place? You have some leader line options, but the most important thing here, you have some formats, is to show levels. So how many levels do you want to show inside of your table of contents or TOC? In this case, I just want 4. I'm going to change the leader lines to this dashed. You have some advanced options here you can explore around with. I'm not going to go into those here. So I have my 4 levels. I'm just going to click OK. And you're going to see the table of contents is built. And now you have that level, where is it? Level here. 1.3 is actually now a level 4. Now from this point, you can also format your table of contents. Notice my arrow here on the left. If I click and hit Control B to bold, notice that the headers, Control B to bold, sometimes you have to do this twice, will change their formatting. You can also just use your mouse here. Notice it's this little tilt. I'll click in. Maybe I want to make all those orange, click orange. So you can still format your table of contents just by hovering your mouse over here on the left. I can make it italicized. It didn't take that time. Control I for italicized. And you can see the formatting is there applied. So that's how you can update and customize your table of contents in Word. Section 3, navigating your table of contents in Word. Now there's a couple of different ways you can navigate your Word document based on your table of contents and the header styles you set up to create your table of contents here in Word. The first way is if you hold the Control key, notice my cursor becomes a hand. If I click a section with that hand, you will jump to that section within your document. And the keyboard shortcut to always get back to the first page is Control Home. Control Home will jump you back to the first page. So that's the first way you can navigate your table of contents here in Word. You just hold the Control key on your keyboard, click the section you want to jump to, and then Control Home to jump back to the first page. Another way you can navigate your document is based on these section headers you set up to create your table of contents in the first place. Notice you can click them. Sometimes they're a little bit sticky. You can click them to collapse them with your mouse. There's also some keyboard shortcuts, which I recommend learning. Alt Shift minus sign will collapse a section header. Alt Shift minus sign. Alt Shift plus sign, all right, give it a shot on your own, will expand those section headers. But it's just doing one at a time. Notice the other ones are not collapsing. If you want to collapse all of your section headers, you're just going to right click with your mouse, expand and collapse. We're going to collapse all headings, which will collapse them to that level 1. We can then Alt Shift plus sign and peek into them. If that's what we want to do, we can then expand them all. Before I move on to the next way to navigate your document, just expand all headings and it will just look like all of the text open with all of those section headings. So that's another way that you can navigate your document after you've set up these header styles in your document. A third way you can do it is if you come to the View tab, you come to the Navigation pane. Notice here, as long as you're clicked into the heading styles, you can click these headings to jump around within your document. You can also right-click these, expand, collapse, etc. So this is another fast way. And if you have a big screen, I actually usually leave this open as I'm writing my Word document because then I can just see where the different sections are, the subsections, etc. Click them with my mouse to jump to that area within my document. But if you do need more screen space, just close it out and you get the normal working environment. Now the last way you might want to navigate your document once you have it all set up like this is if you come to the View tab and you come to the Outline view. Notice here in the outline view, you have a couple of options. First off, you can show levels. So I can show levels, just show level 1. I can just show level 2. I can just show level 3. So that's level 1, level 2, level 3. You can use these signs to expand or collapse the section that you have highlighted. You can also, let's say you want section 4 of your document to really be section 1. Instead of trying to copy and paste, you can just click this up. Notice my section 4 walks all the way to the top of my document. Now it's there. I can just click the plus sign if I want to. So this is another great way if you're building a long document, maybe you're writing a book, that you can expand and collapse your sections. You can move them around very easily here in the outline view. When you're done with the outline view, just click the outline, close outline view, and you go back to the normal view, control home of your document. Bonus, converting Word to PowerPoint. Let's say that this is my presentation outline here in Microsoft Word, and I want to quickly convert all of this content into PowerPoint slides to jumpstart my presentation without manually copying and pasting my titles and content back and forth between Word and PowerPoint. To do that, you'll first want to format your document. Header 1 will be your titles, and I'm using this very cool, if I just hover for a second, black and white numbering. You want your title to be level 1. You want your content to be level 2 or level 3. I usually just go level 2. So I'm going to use my shortcuts, Control-Alt-1 for the title, Control-Alt-2 for the content, Control-Alt-1, Control-Alt-2. So you first need to just format your document just as if you were creating a table of contents in Word. Now I'm purposely going to forget Title 5 and Title 6. So Slide 5 and 6, I'm not going to format and watch what happens, all right? Now I need to save my document. I'll F12, save it somewhere where I can grab it really quickly, my desktop. I'll click Save. I'll overwrite the one I was practicing with. You then need to control out of your document, control W to close out, come and find PowerPoint. Here in the blank presentation, home tab, slide drop down, slides from outline, go and select the document you saved, click insert, it'll go to work, and your slides will automatically import here into Microsoft PowerPoint. Now, right off the bat, you can see that my formatting from Word came over into my document, which is not the correct formatting for this template. So holding Shift, I will select the slides and reset them. I'm also going to select the title slide. I'm then going to quickly apply the template that Camille has set up for me so that I can quickly start to build out this presentation. You're obviously going to want to break out your text into more visuals. But if you want to learn how to build a PowerPoint template from scratch with Camille, check out our free mini series here on YouTube. So that's how to make a table of contents in Word and some clever tricks for quickly formatting, updating, and navigating your Word document using your table of contents. If you found this video helpful, please let me know with a quick thumbs up here on YouTube, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel with the notification bell turned on if you want to keep up to date on our latest tutorials that will help get you to happy hour. If you have a question about anything I covered here, let me know in the comments section below and I'll try to address that in my next video. This is Taylor from Nuts and Bolts Speed Training, and I'll see you at happy hour.